foundation of all scripture. Matthew 22, 37 through 40 says, Jesus said unto him, Thou shalt love the Lord thy God maintain order and worship as they assist the priest. They were both on their way home from Jerusalem. They were going down as opposed to going up to Jerusalem. Why did I not help the man? Many excuses, many reasons could be given. Some have suggested that they thought he was dead. And if they had touched him, they would have been ceremonially defiled. They would become ceremonially unclean. And they would not be able to serve a temple for a period of time. But notice they were not going to temple. They were going from temple. Isn't it strange how we behave badly when we leave church? We're in church worshiping, we're singing praise and worship, we're served, we're shouting hallelujah, we're praising the Lord, we're giving up everything for Jesus. But as soon as we get out of the door, served locked up everybody. They went on trial and their whole character came out before the court. All the mistakes they ever made in their lives came out. The prosecutor got every witness he could gather against them. And they were convicted and sent to jail because they failed to be a good Samaritan. They didn't care. They were having fun. That's why these men passed by. They were busy with their own schedules. They were focused on themselves. They were too self-absorbed to get involved. They were religion at its worst. They kept their traditions and their laws. They wrote the law themselves. But they failed the greatest test of all. Do you love your neighbor as yourself? This will be the law that all of us will be judged by. James chapter 2 verse 12 says, so speak ye and so do as they that shall be judged by the law of liberty. For he shall have judgment without mercy that hath showed no mercy. And mercy rejoiceth against judgment. Let me read that verse 13 for you again. For he shall have judgment without mercy that hath showed no mercy. And mercy rejoiceth against judgment. The Good Samaritan. The fact that Jesus called the Samaritan good is very interesting. Most Pharisees would have considered no Samaritan to be good. As I told you before, the Samaritans, after the Assyrian invasion of Israel in 722 BC, the Jews intermarried with other nationalities that were brought to live in Israel by the Assyrians. So they were no longer pure Jewish lineage in Christ's time. They were rejected by Orthodox Jews. A great racial divide existed between the two groups. The Samaritans lived in the eastern portion of Israel with their own temple on Mount Gerizim. Since they were not permitted in Jerusalem temple, they had their own temple. Jewish rabbis avoided entering Samaritan cities, but Jesus often went to Samaria. and say to my wife, well, you know, Brother so-and-so didn't look too right to me. Something was almost out of awe. She said, so-and-so was a bit distracted. How do I see all of these things? Because I'm at a vantage point. And then it becomes a burden on my heart, and I have to pray for that person because something didn't seem right. Just didn't seem right. Mm-hmm. See, the preacher who pays attention prays. Hallelujah. I see when I preach and you duck, as if I'm throwing stones. Sight. Sight. I said, whew. stop for a moment. Stop for a moment. That's why Jesus gave you the Holy Spirit. Stop for a moment and pour in some oil and some wine. He says, every good you do costs me.
Yes.
He says, every good you do costs you. And it should cost you. David said when he went to buy the property to offer a sacrifice to God, the owner of the property said, oh, King David, take it. You're King David. David said, I will never offer anything to God that does not cost me something. Lastly,
presence of his glory with exceeding joy. To the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and forevermore.